This week at the Internet Cafe, Voyeurism Online. This is a website called homecams.com, your guide to sites where people are using webcams to let you peek in on their day-to-day lives. One of these people is Christine. She runs the Housewife Cam, where you can follow her around day and night. If you want to see the best of home cam shots, go to this website, an archive of memorable moments from various live cam locations. This is Chip of Chip Cam. He decided the chat rooms were kind of boring, so he's added a live cam to his website. And this is an innovative website at Stanford, where you can control the webcam and pan, tilt, or zoom to see just the picture you want. Plus, meet the internet version of the Brady Bunch, mom, dad, and the kids, living their lives live online. Voyeurism on the web, this week at the Internet Cafe. NetCafe is made possible by rondiamond.com, the oldies site on the internet. Music and memories from the 50s, 60s, and 70s, not just another jukebox. Additional support comes from the law offices of Ivan Hoffman, lawyering with integrity for internet law, copyright, trademark, and other intellectual property law. And by TechWeb for up-to-the-minute technology news.
All right, voyeurism on the net. Now, we've seen lots of cameras, webcams, that we're looking at fish, you know, and looking at boring stuff. Now we're looking at people getting undressed, you know, and going to the bathroom.
Yeah.
I mean, why are people interested in this stuff?
I think it's human nature.
Really?
I think we're very curious about what goes on behind people's private lives. Look at how much people are in love with celebrities right now.
Yeah.
And I think this is just the next natural extension. Forget about, you know, Pamela
neighbor.
Anderson and Tommy Lee. Let me go see what my neighbor is doing, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
Especially if it's a she and she walks around with not too much clothes on, because that's what's driven a lot of this stuff.
That's true.
Chicks
yes?
online, yeah.
Chicks online, there you go. I mean, there's a little sort of sexual connotation to most of this stuff in a way, right?
I've got better things to do with my time. I don't get it.
In terms of watching.
Yeah.
But how about, would you have a webcam in your house?
Never.
Who needs it?
Not gonna
You're a normal
happen.
Person.
Twisted.
Well,
yeah.
Some people want their 15 minutes of fame.
Well, I think that's the other side
and
of it. It's not just voyeurism. Maybe
right?
The show's about exhibitionism.
Right?
Yeah.
George, you have created the Noses Home Cam page. And when we say home cam, we're talking about something a little bit different. It's not a traditional webcam. It's not the weather outside or something that a company has put out. But these are people in their house having cameras on them 24 hours a day. Now, first of all, why do people want to watch this? It's not as exciting, in my opinion, as like TV or, you know, some of the movies or something. What is going on here that people are drawn to?
Actually, in some ways, it's even more exciting than TV.
So I'm missing something.
I've heard a lot of comments from people that it's better than TV because it's real.
Okay.
Because it is real people living real lives in their homes.
Okay. And there has been popular stuff like that on TV, too, real TV. So.
Correct.
Yeah, right.
But
yeah,
even that is edited.
So this is unedited,
live,
life.
Right now, someone's life.
Okay, now how did this start? I mean, has this been around for a while?
It's a rather new phenomenon. It's been around for about 6 months now.
Okay.
When I started my site in early July, there were 5 cameras.
Okay.
There are now about 175 listed on the site.
So in 6 months, it went from 5 to 175 cameras.
Correct. I've seen it double every week for a while. It was scary.
Really? Wow. Now, who started the first site?
The very first site was the Jenny Cam.
Okay.
And Jenny was a college student who decided to put her life out on cam.
It was in the dorm or something?
Started off in
her
dorm.
Okay.
And she's been doing that for well over a year now.
Okay. And now you've seen it grown. What are the other kind of sites that have come online that you have up on your site?
There is everything ranging from women on cam who are out there looking for attention, guys on cam who are busy chatting with people, groups of people, either dorm cams or whatnot, and out-and-out family cams, the living room, the kitchen.
Really?
You know, just a slice of American family life.
So, I mean, when you first hear about this, you kind of think, well, okay, it's probably the, you know, more sexual or the voyeuristic kind of things that are going to be the most popular, but you're saying it's now going beyond that as well?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, there are all categories. There is certainly the voyeuristic aspect.
Would you say that's the most popular right now, or?
It is. It is the most popular.
Okay. But the other areas are growing.
Oh, absolutely. And as a matter of fact, as time goes on, I have a feeling we'll get more normal people leading normal lives in front of their camera.
Okay. Now, if people go up on your site to look at some of these different areas, are they categorized or how do they go on and find that stuff?
Well, I break down the sites into a number of categories, basically men, women, groups, and families.
Okay.
And family cams are what I would consider to be the true home cams. Usually it's a static camera showing you what's going on in that room right now.
So you can watch the kids playing or even the family watching TV. You can be watching them.
There's a family who set up a camera in their living room to watch what their dogs do while they're away at work.
Hey, I would actually like that. I have two cats, and that could be kind of...
You don't trust them. What do they do when you're gone?
Right, exactly. Okay, I see. So people can do that. Now, for the future, I mean, is this going to become a big business thing, or you see this as staying, you know, that it's going to be people just doing this for the fun of it?
I suspect as the technology gets even easier, and it's very easy right now, that we will have more and more people doing this and become a very common thing.
So basically in the internet world, everybody's going to have their own television show.
Exactly.
Right. All right, well, we're going to have to check it out.
Great.
All right, Chip, you run ChipCam, which is your personal live cam, home cam, and part of your website, I guess. Is Chip your real name, by the way, or is that a persona for the website?
No, now it's my real name. It was originally a nickname that got added to my name legally.
All right. Yeah. What is the idea behind ChipCam? I mean, why add a picture to what you're already doing on your website, a live camera?
Well, my website is a personal website. It's a place where I share my ideas, I do personal writing, and provide that content to people on the net. Adding the camera adds a bit of a personal dimension. So not only can people come and see, read my words, but they can see who wrote the words. And
now, why is a live cam better than just putting up a snapshot of yourself? Hey, this is what Chip looks like.
Well, snapshot is more like a posed or staged piece of media, where the camera just captures me when I'm doing. Sometimes I have a weird expression on my face, or sometimes I'm not there. It's more real.
Now, is this a 24-hour thing? I mean, you have your chip cam on the whole time and we follow your life like the Jennies and the Annas and all that?
No, I turn it on when I'm there and more when I'm present on my webpage.
Okay.
So
it's really tied to the chat aspect of your website, right?
Sure, tied to the chat and to meeting people and offering a bit of myself and hopefully getting a bit back to from the visitors on my site.
What's the next step? I mean, where do you see this live cam stuff going? What would you like to do if you had, you know, more bandwidth, for example?
What I'd like to do is create a place where more people with more cams and more communications methods can contribute and collaborate with each other to create something that's greater.
Greater in what way? I mean, what's the experiment that's going on here?
Just to bring people together to share ideas and be creative with each other.
And just really make more of a social experience, a real social...
Social experience, and see how people can create things with each other.
What's the psychology behind this all? You know, the live cams, the voyeurism on the web. Why do you think people care to watch what Chip is doing 7 o'clock on a Monday night? I mean, who cares? Why are they interested?
Well, I think people really have the need to reach out to other people. Hmm. And in real life, a lot of people might not have the mechanism or the social structure to do it. Now that the internet is so readily available, that's a whole bunch of people who are already there. And a mechanism for people to reach out and find other people.
Is sex a big part of this whole live cam voyeurism thing? I mean, a lot of the sites have a sort of sexual connotation, if not a blatant sexuality to them. I know you've mentioned people log on and say, hey, take your clothes off, Chip.
Sure. Yeah, it gives a someone with voyeuristic tendencies the opportunity to look into someone else's life without identifying themselves. It's anonymous. There's a safety barrier. I can look, but, you know, who I'm looking at doesn't know that I'm there.
Yeah, so there's the anonymity, but, I mean, do you find in the people who log on to your chat room and they know there's a live cam on some guy, I mean, is that part of the communication?
Sure. Some people, you know...
That's not the purpose, though, I take it, for why you're doing
that. No, sex isn't the purpose why I'm doing it, although some people come there and we talk about sex. I don't, you know, take off my clothes on request because it's not a service I'm providing.
Right.
I'm just putting myself on the net and hoping to meet other people.
All right. Well, I want to talk to somebody else who's doing a similar thing, so thanks a lot, Chip.
Sure thing.
And this is another webcam personality, Christine, also known as Housewife Cam. And I guess that's what you're famous for. You've had, what, I think like 10,000 hits a day, I had heard, when you heard you say
that? Yes, that's up to 10,000, sometimes 15,000 hits a day.
Why? What is so interesting about watching you at home?
That's a good question. I think it's just the ability to view somebody's life, to be a part of somebody's life, to just see what they do in a day and what their daily life is like. And
was that your, I mean, what was your idea behind creating Housewife Cam?
Actually, it happened last summer. My husband and I were just
messing
throwing
around?
Ideas around, and we had been on CUCME for quite a while and liked the whole camera aspect, and he started playing around with the webcam software, and before you know it, I've got my own page. So
is there, let me ask you this, is there a kind of sexual connotation to it? I mean, you're a very attractive woman, and we know there's a lot of sort of sex underlying, if not more specific stuff, in a lot of the webcam stuff. Is part of it just there's a good-looking lady who walks around sometimes with not too much clothes on?
I would imagine that's a big part of it. But, yeah, I think it's not as intimidating to people when they can view you on screen and they don't have to worry about making conversation with you. Or.
But how about from your side? I mean, if you go to your site, I mean, there's shots of you there sort of topless at the keyboard or hanging around and, you know, small clothing.
Well, usually
is that sort of is there an exhibitionist side to why you do it?
I have no problems with showing myself off, and generally I'm sitting there answering emails to people who are emailing.
So you're just working as you might normally.
Yeah,
just hot in the house.
That's right. Reading news groups, whatever's happening, and.
But I mean, you've got. I know when you go to your homepage, I mean, it's got what bedroom cam, I think,
bedroom
which
cam.
Starts to suggest well, there's what's going on this website.
Well, unfortunately, bedroom cam's not up yet. We're still working on that one. But I do plan on eventually expanding it into that. And unfortunately, my husband doesn't want any part of it, so it'll have to be mainly when he's not there.
Well, so. I wanted to ask you about that, because I know you say somewhere on your website, well, your husband is like really not too thrilled with what you're doing there. Is that just because he doesn't like you walking around in the underwear or whatever?
I don't think it's so much that. I think he thinks it may take too much of my time or...
It's a dumb hobby.
Yeah, somebody may get a weird idea in their head, or who knows. But
I mean, your husband's a techie type guy, right?
Yes, he is. He helped me with the whole thing. So.
What kind of feedback have you gotten at all? I mean, do people try to find you, meet you, get involved in some way?
The feedback I've gotten is very positive. It's people are just very interested in it, and they're very interested in my life, what I do on a daily basis. What I'm thinking. But
has it changed what you do on a daily basis or how you think?
No, it doesn't. I know I used to get up in the morning and go on there with my cup of coffee and my hair back and no makeup.
Well, I recognize you here in CyberSmith, so
I guess I'm not
too different. Somehow. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Chris, what exactly is a webcam archivist?
Somebody who collects images from a webcam and categorizes them for people to view at a later time.
Is this like a new industry, or is there more than just one of you out there?
There's lots of people who are doing archives. Anna, I think, probably has about 10 different people who are doing archives. Some of them just simply collect the images and store them on the system. Some of them do like me and break them up so that you can view them in a little bit more organized manner.
So I think it's important to say that you're basically archiving Anna Vogue's website, and Anna's on... in front of her webcam, 7 days a week, 24 hours a day.
Absolutely.
And now, how exactly are you archiving Anna?
I've got a camera or a computer that's capturing images 24 hours a day, saving them off the hard disk. I then go through those and kind of filter through them, pull out the important stuff, and get rid of the rest of it, and put it online.
So you have basically a little story that you can see what Anna's day was like. Now, help me understand this. What kind of people are going to this website? I mean, why?
Primarily, I think voyeurs go originally. You know, they're out looking for naked women online.
Yeah.
Anna happens to be on many sites that collect links to these sites, and so they end up there.
So what's Anna all about? Is this a sex site?
Absolutely not. No, Anna's about all kinds of things. A lot of paradoxical things.
How so?
You know, she says her site's not about sex, but there's certainly a bunch of nudity, and there's actually been sex on the site.
Well, if she's on 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. There's a whole bunch of things, not just sex, that are happening on there, too. So now, what do you think prompts Anna to do this?
Partially that she's a bit of an exhibitionist. Part of it, I think that she's a performer. She enjoys performing.
So she does do performances, actually.
Absolutely.
Like, you know, is it every day, or is it
No,
every
but she
so
feels
often?
Like it when she's motivated, when she's inspired.
And she is actually a musician as well.
Absolutely.
I mean,
she's
not
got,
just
she
in
got
front
a,
of the
a new record coming out beginning of the year. With Radioactive Records. I think they're a subsidy of Sony.
So how did you get linked up with Anna?
I was on a site that was all about webcams, and she showed up one day and was talking about the webcam that she was going to start in about a month or so. And she pointed a couple of us off to her Radioactive site, where they have a record and stuff about her, and we clicked.
The rest is history.
Yeah, so.
So now tell me, you spend a lot of time behind the computer, as it were, or behind the camera. Are you going to do the same thing? Are you going to get in front of the camera and track your life?
I'd like to. I have a studio at home, and I'd like to do the studio cam when I'm playing music, you know, turn it on, have people see what I'm doing.
But just when you're playing your music.
Yeah, I have a full-time job during the day, too, so I guess that might be interesting to watch me sit in front of a computer all day.
No, that's okay, unless you're doing some really interesting things.
Yeah.
But so tell me, what's the future? I mean, is everybody going to have a webcam at home and be online? And
I think more and more people are going to be broadcasting video over the web as we get higher and higher bandwidth.
But
out
at
our homes.
Home? Showing your life? Is this
possibly,
what it's all about?
Possibly.
The World Wide Web in a new dimension.
Yeah. I've actually been working on another site that's kind of like a TV station format of webcams. So you take the various cams and you give everybody a slot during the day. Here's your hour, here's your hour. And then people can do performance. And you don't go and just watch somebody 24 hours a day.
So that's a whole different experience.
But you'd actually see various people on webcams doing various different things.
Sounds pretty interesting, Chris.
Yeah.
Here at CyberSmith tonight is Larry Maggot, syndicated columnist with the LA Times, contributing editor to Home PC. We're going to kind of take advantage of your being here, Larry, and pick your brain a bit. In this show we're doing on voyeurism tonight, a lot of parents watch this and say, oh my goodness, my kids might be looking at some of this stuff that may not be appropriate. There may be nudity, sexual content. You're a parent. Is there some simple advice how to manage your kids and keep them from these kinds of sites?
Well, I don't know fully how to manage kids. If I did, I'd be a world-renowned expert. But I do know you have to talk to them to begin with, and you really have to instill in them a certain amount of judgment. If that doesn't work, if you really feel your kids are going to go and do something dangerous, then you do have the option of installing filters, basically software that will prevent them from going to
what
certain
kinds. What are some
examples? NetNanny, SurfWatch, Cyber Patrol are three of the better
and
known
how do
products.
They work?
What they do is they have hidden lists of basically bad sites that are sexually explicit, perhaps racist, violent, that you feel are inappropriate, and they prevent your kid from going there. Now, it's important that you configure them. Don't just install it and go with the defaults. You have to look.
You can set the parameters.
Absolutely. You can decide what it is that you need to filter out for your kids. The other thing that they do is that they actually prevent or can be configured to prevent the kid from typing something that might get them into trouble, like their name, like their home address, their phone number, where their parents work. So they're not. Don't just filter out what comes into the computer. They can actually filter out what the kid can put out.
And do they really work?
They work, however, there are a couple of caveats. Number one, they're not perfect. There are sites that will get in. And two, they may block things that you might want your kids to use.
Larry, thanks a lot.
My pleasure.
You know, there's a lot of people with a lot of cams out there for a whole bunch of different reasons. Now, what brought you two together to do Dave and Liz's cam? What's that all about?
Basically family, being so far away from family.
So now, what's the setup? What have you got? Dave, what's how's it all set up? You're the techno guy behind the scenes.
Well, it's a Kinectix quick cam, utilizing iSpy capture software. And what it does is every 2 minutes from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Pacific, it uploads an image to our website automatically.
So now basically you've got, now where's the cam? The cam's in the living room, right?
Cam's in the living room,
so,
yes.
But it stays in the living room all the time. So it's living room activity we're
typically,
talking about.
Typically, we have extension cords. We can pick up and move the camera anywhere basically in-house we want to.
Now you've got a family, you've got three kids and yourselves that hang out in the living room, the TV's there and lots of other things going on. What prompted you to do this? I mean, what was the motivation behind having this?
Well, we've been involved with the online community for many years, from running a bulletin board to being FidoNet. We finally got onto the web. This was a natural progression to say hi to friends, family, meet new people and experiment.
So it's been kind of an interesting experience. Now, Liz, let me ask you, what do the kids think?
The kids have a blast with it. They like to get up and wave at the camera and talk.
So they get pretty engaged. They don't forget the camera's there.
No, not really.
Okay. Now, what do their friends think?
Their friends think it's cool.
They're going
and
right
interesting.
On. How about your girlfriends? Now that's the next question. I mean, what about your friends and family? What do they think about you guys being online with this cam in your house?
Interesting.
I haven't heard any negative feedback. My stepmom gets online, she'll check to see if we're at home, then she'll send us an instant message, say, hi, I saw you, come chat with me. You know, so it's a way of letting family and friends know that we're okay.
So now, tell me a little bit about what your website looks like. You've got more than just the cam there, right?
Yes. We have a gallery of photographs and artwork. Every month we'll go in and change it out. Some months it'll be our son's artwork, our daughter's artwork, our pictures from trips. We also have an area that describes everyone in our family, a photograph of of our daughters, photograph of our son, and of us saying, okay, this is who we are, and this is what we like to do.
Now, that kind of leads me to the next obvious question. There's a lot of fear out there, especially when it comes to kids getting online or getting into chat rooms or those types of things. But what you've now done is you've got this webcam in your house, and your kids are there and everything. Are you frightened that, you know, some crazy's going to be out there who's a voyeur and he's checking out things and, you know, hones in on your kids? Is that a fear of yours? Is it something you're concerned about?
Not really, because cyberspace has this air of anonymity. What it does is we don't go on and say, okay, this is who we are, this is where we live. We're just on the web, we're Dave and we're Liz, and we're out there, and some people come in and say hi to us or whatever. But as far as fears, is someone coming and breaking into our house? Nah.
So it's pretty much friendly stuff. You get emails and stuff, and they're all pretty positive responses to what's going on.
Pretty much, or they're asking for help how to set up their cam.
Wow, so it's the next wave of the future. Everybody's going to have a webcam at home.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, Sean, you're on the staff at Stanford, and I think you did your parents proud. You were doing a research project as a student, and now you're hired full time. But we're talking about webcams and home cams, and you've done something a little bit different, basically a webcam that people can control by remote. What is the project you're involved with about?
It's all about just moving a camera and being able to view a space remotely.
So anybody can go online and control the cameras in your project.
Right. Anyone around the world can come. They can pan the camera left and right, tilt it up and down, and they can actually zoom in on objects in the room.
So you, basically anybody is the cinematographer at this point.
Right.
What do you have to show? what spaces are they looking at?
Currently it's a loft space that's used by an engineering class at Stanford.
Okay.
And they have teams of students who are working on projects there, and they have remote members who need to be able to see what the local teams are doing.
Okay, so it's a collaborative, sort of an educational tool that people can use.
Right.
Where do you see this type of technology going in the future in terms of, like, applications beyond education?
I could also see it in the business world, anywhere where a remote collaboration is a benefit, as well as, say, sporting events, and I get a lot of requests.
Hey, that's a good idea. So you can watch a football game and pan the camera where you wanted to, or things like that.
You can, you know, look at someone in the crowd if you feel like it, instead of watching the game, or just get another view.
Okay, interesting. Now, to create this site, I think you actually had to create some technology, some new things. It's not just your standard off-the-shelf a webcam. What did you do?
Well, what I did was I took an off-the-shelf pan and tilt mechanism.
Which is this piece right here.
Black piece here, and you see just a standard quick cam sitting on top of that.
Right.
And what I did was I built some hardware and wrote some software in order to control that through the web.
Now, you've taken it a step further also. You have a site, I know, where basically the camera is on you while you're at work. What does it feel like to be the subject of the viewers all the time?
Well, for me, it's no big deal. I get an audio warning whenever someone gets on the camera, so I know someone's there.
So what, a buzzer goes off or a sound or something?
Right, a little sound file plays and tells me someone's there.
Right.
And I'm used to it.
Okay.
I don't care, you know. Okay. I'll usually make faces at people if someone's on the camera.
Now, have you found that other people maybe aren't so comfortable with it?
Other people can't stand it. They'll turn the cameras around or do anything they can to get the camera off of them.
Really?
Okay. So it's a matter of getting used to it.
Right. So you don't think this is something that'll probably be standard in the workplace soon?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, hopefully in the near future.
Well, we got to see some examples and meet some of these people who do the webcam stuff. I mean, we saw Chip and Christine and the couple you interviewed. What do you think now? Does this make sense to you?
I think it makes sense. Not so much from doing it. I'm not excited to get
behind. You
wouldn't
put a webcam
in
your house.
No, I can't see having one in my house.
But
my room's too messy. But watching was actually pretty interesting.
In what way?
Well, you know, I'm a guy, and I was something sort of excited about being
Chick
a boy.
Walking around in underwear.
Exactly. You know, it's something out of your ordinary everyday life. So I was kind of intrigued.
And Jane, what would you
think?
It's
a guy thing.
It's a guy thing.
It's definitely
a guy
thing.
So the whole thing is boring to you?
I just think it's crazy.
You wouldn't put a camera in your kitchen or your bedroom?
No.
And you don't care to watch other people's private
lives? Not particularly.
Show me a good movie, huh?
Thank you very much.
All right, well, you'll have to make up your own mind about voyeurism on the web. That's it for this edition of the Internet Cafe.
NetCafe is made possible by rondiamond.com, the oldies site on the Internet. Music and memories from the 50s, 60s, and 70s, not just another jukebox. Additional support comes from the law offices of Ivan Hoffman, lawyering with integrity for internet law, copyright, trademark, and other intellectual property law. And by TechWeb, for up-to-the-minute technology news.
To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.